This morning, Wimps is at OGM Music Center with Stuart Bailie, music journalist, former editor in New Musical Express and BBC Radio Ulster presenter, as well as chief executive officer here at the center. Could you tell me what's for you the soundtrack of the travels?
I was a teenager in the mid-70s, late-70s. And for me, it was a very exciting era because we had punk rock, and punk rock was quite a rebellious form of music. And in Northern Ireland, the rebellion took the form of protesting about sectarianism, protesting about bigotry. So the interesting songs would have been made by bands like Stiff Little Fingers. And to me, the most exceptional song was called Alternative Ulster. Mm-hmm. And we have a picture, we have a lyric from Alternative Ulster on our wall. Uh-huh. And the lyric is, grab it and change it, it's yours. So basically what they're saying in that song is that you don't have to follow the problems and the traditions of your parents if they're not good traditions, or if they are bigoted or sectarian thought processes. So punk rock was very exciting in that way, and it had allowed a generation to think about a different future for Northern Ireland.
Mm-hmm. Is there a politician that you would go a gig with?
I've been to gigs with quite a lot of politicians. Mm-hmm. in Belfast. So, you know, the Lord Mayor has been to two or three events recently that we've been involved in, and there's three or four other people like Conor Maskey, Don Purvis. They're all a little bit rock and roll in their own way.
How is the music scene in Belfast?
Music scene is fantastic in Belfast. I've seen some very bad years, and I've seen some exceptional years, and the last two or three years I've just seen a very steady increase in talent, in people releasing great records, in terms of a community that supports each act and supports all the creative people and the business people. So it's never been a better time. I would be very excited by the likes of General Fiasco, Cashier Number 9, and So I Watch You From Afar. And there's some singer-songwriters like Anthony Toner and Gareth Dunlop. So it's a good time, it's a busy time.
You were in NIMA 2011, the North of Ireland Music Awards. How was the event?
Well, just before the MTV Awards, there was a week set aside for local music. It was called Belfast Music Week, and that was an amazing week. There was 170 events in 45 venues, and there was workshops, there was community festivals, all sorts of stuff. And right in the middle of it all, we, along with AU Magazine, put together the first ever Northern Ireland Music Awards. And the idea was to try and celebrate local talent. So we hired the Ulster Hall, which was very exciting. It was recorded by BBC Radio Ulster. And there was live music from Japanese pop stars, from General Fiasco, from, oh, there's so many, I can't remember, and So I Watch You From Afar. And at the end of the night, we gave a special award to Stiff Little Fingers. It was a legend award, and that was really to celebrate the fact that they did so much for us during very difficult times. It was a great night, very busy, very exciting.
Well, thanks for everything, Stuart.
You're very welcome, thank you.